Watch what's approaching. The supreme moment. Reality striking closer than it seems, don't it? Go ahead, it's for the taking if you want it. If not, the dream dies and you'll be forever haunted. Then confront it.
What's good? So I was working pretty late last night, and just before going back into the office, I'm gonna go ahead and cover this stuff because it is a lot of exciting news. I'm sure a couple of you guys have already seen this on the Twitter, but Dokkan Official has released information about the 300 million download celebration live stream event. So we know for a fact, first of all, there is going to be a 300 million download celebration coming up at the end of the month. And that's certainly good because they've kept pretty much the same schedule that they have the past couple years. So 300 million download celebration is definitely going to be a very exciting time. You know all the stuff that happens with that, all the stuff that happened last year with the tickets, you know, based on how many Dragonstones you spent. A lot of new banners. You know, last year we had the Transforming Goku and Frieza, as well as the LR Goku and Frieza in the second half. So a lot of stuff coming up. So related to this news on the 300 million download celebration, it is going to be a live event. So what I'm going to do, since it's scheduled on August 17th at 8 p.m. JP time, it's technically going to be 13 hours ahead. So it'll be August 17th, Saturday morning for me at like 7 a.m. So I plan on doing a live stream, and I'll provide pretty much real-time translations on the spot while watching the live event itself. So, you know, you guys are certainly, you know, welcome to join the live stream that I, you know, definitely plan on scheduling. So I'll definitely update you guys closer to the date and just remind you guys that I'll be doing that. But, you know, I certainly do plan on covering as much details as I can when that live event is available. I heard that there are going to be, similar to the 4-year anniversary live stream event, there's going to be during the live stream, there's going to be missions for Dragonstones to be kind of rewarded in the game. So the more we find out, the more I'll cover. So for the time being, just know that I will plan on doing a live stream and kind of providing translations for the event itself. Alright, so moving on to the new cards for the Peppy Gal. So, of course, there's been news out about it, and if you haven't heard about it, let's go ahead and cover some of the information. So there's going to be a lot of stuff. Quite a few of these will be Dokkan Awakenings, but there is going to be a new launch unit coming out, and it's about damn time, honestly. I actually had the SR version at like Max SA, hoping that eventually she would get a Dokkan Awaken, but you know, it is going to be a new unit. But what's funny is it's also a strength type, right? And the SR version is also a strength type, so it's pretty interesting. I'm not exactly sure, you know, why they did that, but it is what it is. Based on the stats I see, I mean, it's obviously going to be a summonable unit just because of the leader skill and all that. So we'll cover it one by one. We'll start off with the Super Intelligence Brienne de Chateau unit. So this will be a Dokkan Awaken. Max stats are going to be 12,696. Attack is 13,866. Defense is 9,716. Leader skills, Peppy Gals and Transformation Boost category. Key plus 3. HP, attack, and defense increase of 120%. For the super attack, she will cause supreme damage and also seals enemy SA. For the passive, this is a little bit interesting. I almost feel like this is missing information from DBZ space for the full passive. I'm not, you know, 100% on it, but all that's listed is basically blooms on the battlefield, or, you know, some sort of shit goes down, basically. But I almost feel like there's missing information. Like, why would you only have a passive skill for a potential, you know, I don't know, transformation or whatever? So I'm not entirely sure what the full passive is. Maybe it is, I don't know, but I'm gonna leave it at that for now. So it is a transforming unit, transform at the start of turn. And then for the links, you have Battlefield Diva, Metamorphosis, the Innocent Signature Pose, More Than Meets Eye, Tournament of Power, and Shattering the Limit. Categories are Peppy Gal's Universe Survival Saga and Transformation Boost. And then once transformation takes place to Ribrianne, the passive skill is Attack and Defense, increase of 120%, plus an additional Attack and Defense increase of 10%, and all enemies Attack and Defense minus 10%, up to minus 30% per Peppy Gal's category ally on the team. And then Peppy Gal's category allies also get plus 2 key in attack and defense, increase of 30%. There's a lot of information on that one, and we'll see, you know, what the deal is with the before transform state of the passive skill. I'm not entirely sure what the deal is with that. This is another Dokkan Awakening, the super physical type Chichi unit. It is a youth unit, so it'll be on the Dragon Ball Saga. Max stats is HP 12,620, attack is 13,752, defense is 9,697. Leader skills, intelligence and physical types, key plus 3, HP, attack and defense, increase of 70%. Super attack will cause supreme damage and a high chance to stun the enemy. And then for the passive skill, it's an attack increase of 250% when performing a super attack, an attack decrease of 50% for 3 turns after receiving an attack. Also, defense increase of 150% when there's a Youth Goku or Kid Goku ally on the team. Links include Battlefield Diva, The Innocence, More Than Meets the Eye, The Incredible Adventure, Guidance of the Dragon Balls, and Shattering the Limit. So 2 categories for the Chichi unit, Youth, and Dragon Ball Saga. So let's go to the most important one, or the most exciting one, is the Super Strength Launch Unit. Max stats 12,528, attack is 13,638, defense is 9,087. Leader skills, Peppy Gauss category, key plus 3, HP, attack and defense, increase of 100%. Super attack causes supreme damage and also lowers enemies' attack and defense. Passive skill is attack and defense increase of 100%, and for 5 turns from the start of battle, key plus 3, an additional attack increase of 50%. Also, high chance to activate criticals and guaranteed additional attack with a high chance for that to be a super attack. So, quite impressive for passive skill on that one. Links include Flea, Metamorphosis, Berserker, Battlefield Diva, Incredible Adventure, and Guidance of the Dragon Balls. And then for the categories, Peppy Gauss and Dragon Ball Saga. Lastly, it's going to be an Extreme Agility Oceanus Shenron unit. Max stats is going to be HP 11,589, attack 13,351, defense is 10,116. Leader skills, Shadow Dragon Saga category, key plus 3, and HP, attack, and defense increase of 100%. So, pretty decent Shadow Dragon Saga category lead. If you don't have the Omega Shenron, it's slightly better than the GT Spirit Bomb Goku as well. I think the Goku was 70% if I'm not mistaken. Super attack causes supreme damage to enemy and also seals enemy SA. Passive skill is key plus 2, attack and defense increase of 100%. If targeted enemy has attack or defense lowered, an additional attack increase of 50% and guaranteed additional super attack. And if targeted enemy has SA sealed, high chance to stun the enemy as well. So a lot of built-in, you know, additional attacks for a chance to become super attacks built in a lot of new units lately. I personally think it's a good thing. It definitely diversifies a lot more options, you know, on potential builds. Links include Metamorphosis, Cold Judgment, Speedy Retribution, Battlefield Diva, GT, and Shadow Dragons. Looks like category Shadow Dragon Saga and Peppy Gauss. I do want to note that the launch unit is max level of 100, so hopefully she does get a Dokkan Awaken at some point. I believe the Oceanus unit is the same deal, max level 100, so maybe at some point in the future we'll see TUR state for those units. But the other two, Chichi and Brianna, are obviously Dokkan Awakenings and definitely improved a little bit. So a lot of stuff coming up. I don't know how much of a high importance you guys are placing on the Peppy Gauss banner coming up for JP, but you know, for every stone that's consumed up until the deadline, you do get tickets out of that. So you know, do also keep that in mind. And 300 million downloads celebration, when that, you know, when all the news starts dropping, it's going to be very exciting. We'll see what kind of units are going to be introduced on the banners. You know, obviously I think there's going to be 2 separate occasions. We'll definitely have 2 different banners during the entire celebration period, like, you know, one at the very beginning and then one at the second half. If it's anything similar to last year, we'll have somewhat, you know, something like a dual Dokkan festival, and then the potentially legendary banner coming up in the second half. Like last year, it was basically a dual Dokkan fest with transforming Goku and transforming Frieza, and then in the second half, during September, we had the LR Goku and Frieza legendary batter. So, you know, a lot of definitely a lot of possibilities. I think many of us are wanting that, transforming Gohan and Cell dual Dokkan Fest to come up. That's seems like what everybody pretty much wants at this point. In terms of the LR, who knows, honestly, you know. It's all speculation at this point, but as more, you know, I don't know, 300, anytime it's a download celebration period, it's a pretty hyped up period. So whatever happens, I think it's going to be exciting nevertheless. So as more information comes out, definitely plan on me I'll definitely be covering that to whatever extent I can. And then for the live event scheduled on August 17th, I will be doing a live stream, so definitely catch that if you can. I'll provide the translations on the spot so you guys can, you know, find out information as soon as possible. All right, that's it for this video. Hopefully you found it helpful, and thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys later. All right, peace out.